we're back.
So, yeah, touch around a bit, so Karsten's gonna get free track again. And we'll be able to push. Kinda a long pit stop. We see the RLMS Ferrari there. Well, I just did that out of my head, and the Ferrari made a faster stop. There's still the Racing Association, I believe. No. Yeah, that was the Racing Association, so not entirely bad stop. Or let's see if they made a driver swap. Kevin Mass still at the Racing Association to Ferrari. And we have Robin Haase in the RML Racing Team 1 Ferrari, who actually just also pitted. Yeah. So, Daniel Hake is in front, still has to make a pit stop, he's still on only 8 stops. And his teammates did 9 stops. And Wayne just did something with the cameras over there.
No, I haven't touched anything.
Well, we went back to our sim racing TV car, and oh, what's happening over here?
No, I'm changing it. We seem to be the only car in the room. Alright, hang on then. Is that you moving the mouse?
Yeah, I just clicked Sebastian Roan's car on camera angle, and it shows Bitbox.
There's something going on here, hang on a second. Let's have a look. There's a room full of people.
Wow.
There's been... We've had a server... How the hell are we getting a server mismatch?
Yeah, we have a problem with the Gallardo.
Let's... Yeah, but we shouldn't, because we haven't been on here. We've been on here for ages. Right, we'll leave and then come back on, because we can't get a mismatch. Not to that degree, anyway. We've actually been quite stable for the last God knows how long. We haven't logged back in for about 3 hours.
We didn't have any game crashes.
I don't know. Matchmaking back working again. If anyone wants to know.
Oh, that might be the problem, but I doubt it.
Let's see.
Here we go.
Oh, that's an unusual to get a mismatch when you're already in a game.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. But it might be fixed. If not, then we have a problem. And no, we still have something. No, we got it.
What does that say there? Because I can't read German.
It says you entered the game, it's all.
Alright, that's alright.
So, we're good to go. Here we go.
Alright, there you go, cameraman. Let's see, there you go.
Oh no.
We've got the dodgy lights again, look. Oh no, I don't. Well, we can't fix it because all we did last time was restart the server, so.
No, we restarted the game. Yeah, and all the cars have the lights.
Yeah, right, hang on. We'll go restart.
We still have one problem. It should have been cleared. Really soon.
We'll get back to you as quick as we can. Exit. There we go. Yeah, that was it. Good thinking, Jeeves.
And in the meantime, Andrea Schmidt just took the gap down to 14.5 seconds, and in fact was like 7 tenths slower last lap. So he's still pulling the gap down. The gap to 3 White Motorsport is still around 40 seconds. So that gap still staying stable, even after making a stop for new tires. And we're currently trying to fix the annoying headlights for your viewing pleasure.
Oh,
apologies for that.
Natalie Pinkham was on the telly.
Oh, you weren't gonna die with Natalie Pinkham.
Oh man, she adore you, anyway.
He's gonna sing a song. Would you die in my arms tonight?
Well, she would with one of me farts. Right, there you go. Try that.
Okay.
Let's see what we've got with headlights.
Oh, Sebastian Roan is in the pit. Oh, we have still the problem.
No.
And Sebastian is in the pit, so we're gonna check.
Sorry, guys. What you're doing? You are racing with a Sunrise TV car?
We have problems with the headlights. All the cars are getting square headlights, and it doesn't fix when we relock.
But you have 11 laps, race laps.
How?
No, that can't be.
What you doing?
Somebody's stealing our car.
There's 11 laps. We haven't. We're not driving or anything.
Okay.
We had a problem just a minute ago. All the cars disappeared. Like, we were changing cameras, then it was putting us to the pit box for every team.
We had a Gallardo HDV mismatch when we tried to join,
so
we left again.
I know. Yeah, good. If we see another mismatch from another team now, we will restart the session. Yeah? But we wait. Yeah, at the moment everything is fine, and I hope it will be stable again. And please accept the problems with the headlights and do nothing anymore.
Right.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Thank you, guys.
Roger that. Right. No problem.
Right. So back to the live images. So.
Yeah.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we still have the problem with the headlights, but like the big boss just told us, we have to wait. There's nothing we can do about it. We tried it, and in fact, it just looks like we made things worse. So the headlights just became more squarey and more paper viewing. Like I don't know. Really sorry about that, but yeah, it's not in our reach. We can't help it, we can't fix it, too bad. So, please bear with us on that.
Turn camera 11, they're only a second behind the RML racing. It's turn to 9 seconds now, it's the closest battle at the minute.
Here we go, a Ferrari and an Audi. Yes, they're actually quite close. Yeah, it's really unfortunate about the headlights. I really don't know what happened there.
To do with the server's been running now for the best part of 9 hours. And that's what's causing a few problems with graphical errors. Still don't get it, we've managed to do 11 laps.
Yeah, it's kind of a weird bug or so, I don't know.
Because the car hasn't come out of the pits. We've had this before though. There's a couple of races before. It looks like we've been driving the car around when me and Shane was like, no?
Yeah, Shane attacking us again.
Yeah,
can't be any doubt.
So much for the luck of the Irish, you know, you'd be sitting there rubbing his four-leaf clover. You know, well, he's probably rubbing something thinking of Adam.
And Sebastian Roan didn't jump Daniel Faber with the pit stop, and he's now 6.5 seconds behind on Three White Motorsport, a racing car machine. Although Daniel is slightly pulling the gap down to our race leader Andrea Schmidt, but it's still over 38.5 seconds. So he lost 10 seconds during that stint.
Yeah, it's quite a bit of time, isn't it?
Yeah, I wasn't expecting that. And I think Sebastian overrated the strategy a little, or maybe it was the intention to do, but he's now... let me check. Oh, what's that? It now says minus 1 minute 28. Yeah, that's sure not right. So, gotta wait for the live timings there to give us...
Gone up the wall a bit.
Oh, there we go. So, Sebastian Roan is about 41 seconds behind Andrea Schmidt. So, that stint was just maybe a little too much, maybe four laps too much. But I said it again, and I'm gonna say it again. It's still over 3 hours to go. Anything can happen. One disconnection, one wrong foot with a back marker, trying to lap. And it's all over, or it could all be over.
Yes. Certainly going to be interesting to see what's going to happen with the overall winner, though, because there's only 38 seconds, well, 42, if you include down to Sebastian. So 42 seconds cover the top three positions. And even at that, it's a bit more. 48 cover the top four. So with 3 hours and 18 minutes remaining, there's four teams in contention for this right now. You've gone quiet.
Nah, I'm just checking live standings to see if any close battle appearing. Yeah, we got a battle for P5 and 6 with Daniel Hacker and Robin Hase. It's around 2 seconds or so.
Game starts almost 3 o'clock. They must have changed it.
Yeah, still longer than I think.
Although saying that, that sky hasn't changed for a while. I'm wondering whether that's as dark as it gets.
Nah, it
gets
darker.
Handy for us, because Eastern Creek was a nightmare.
We ended up
people asking us to put the name of the drivers above the cars because it helped us out a bit. All you could see, literally, was two headlights and two tail lights driving around the track. You couldn't see what the car was. You know, try and figure out the shape of the car by the shape of the rear lights and such. If this is as dark as it gets, that's kind of helpful for us.
Yeah, and even if it gets too dark, we can't even recognize the cars due to the headlight glitch.
Yeah. What are you eating now? Oh dear, you got worms, man.
What?
Yeah, worms.
I'm not doing anything.
You're eating something.
Yeah, chocolate.
Yeah. Well, though, at least it'll wake you up this one. Have you noticed that, Mo? I haven't felt half as tired now as I did 2 hours ago. That between 6 and 5 hours. It felt like 4 hours every time you looked at the clock. The last hour and a half has been really quick. Hang on, we've got a pit stop. Gaming Team 1, so that's 4th position. Oh, that's unusual. That's their 10th stop. Are we seeing strategy coming into play here? Get the early stop in, you know. So then the last half hour of the race, you've got a nice fresh set of boots on, maybe. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I think they're gonna go for a driver swap right now. Gonna change camera in a second if I can. Sorry for that, I seem to have some small lag issues again, so I'm blaming Shane. Also, Carson Fisher is in the pits for RML Racing Team 2.
Come on, give us a battle, someone. Give us a battle. 1.5 seconds there. Camera 16. That's the closest. That's down to a second now. That's the closest battle on track. That's LSF Racer against RTM Racing. Thank you. rumble right in the
tail. Yeah, he was supposed to see Natalie.
Then Damon, he always stands like he's crapped his pants. I reckon Damon sent his grandson. If you look at him, all I'm saying is look at him, you'll see what I mean.
Yeah, just later, after the race.
The checks. Send the viewers we got.
No.
Bearing in mind, one of those viewers is me, so we won't watch it.
Ask Kurtz.
Oh, you're joking.
No.
What?
Life commitments. Sadly.
Oh, that's gay.
I know. Sorry for that. Well, at least I have been around for 10 hours then.
Yeah, so, yeah.
We can get Shane for the last 2 hours.
Or asking now.
Nico. If I could do that, I would, but I was gonna tell you actually a bit sooner, but I forgot.
Oh
right now.
55, who told you to come?
What?
Yep, and the All-Star Racing just pit.
Again?
Yep.
They just bit it like... that's weird. This can't be right. Oh. Hoffman has taken over, so they did driver swap. And yeah, they lost two positions. So is this going to be critical? That's the question. Oh, and he went wide already, so he is losing time.
There's only 1.4 seconds now. And he's going up 10th to win the leaders now. Whatever happened to both the X Factor? We've got X Factor 1 and 2 running line astern or behind each other, isn't it? They're down in 6th and 7th. So a couple of the cars around here running really, really low rider at the time, which is dodging the curves.
And here we go. He's on the inside.
Yeah, nice job done. Yep. Game, set, and match. With the dodgy headlights.
Yeah, I blame you for the headlights.
Nothing to do with me, it's all you, all this crap started with you.
Nah, I just managed fine. Nah, I want to fix it, but Blitz isn't allowing us, so... You have to do for the last 3 hours now, like this.
Yeah, 3 hours remaining. It's all down to now. Track temp 17 degrees, and we've got 258 laps complete. Not too bad. What do you reckon, Linda, for another 3 hours to go? Which is about 408 laps, maybe. In total, maybe. We'll give or take a couple.
got a battle for the lead. There we go. You're bad, Wayne. You didn't even notice.
No, I'm trying to soak something here. Trying to find the mask and I can't see him, and it's annoying me.
Watching Natalie's boobs. Yeah, that was the battle we were watching before. Wait, what? No, no, I can't do the last 2 hours. I will kill you.
I'm resigning.
They can only resign after a race.
Standing down as manager, I'm promoting you, you're now the manager of the broadcast team. You can hard shake and then fire. I need to be. Old age, small brother. Stream lagging.
Yeah, just a bit. I blame Shane, he's watching. He said he has no computer, and I said, use your phone. And he was like, I have no mic on my phone. What the hell is that for an excuse? Yeah, Shane, you.
You're talking to?
No, but he's just watching. Just a pure guess.
thinking on next pit stops. I think it's Ronnie's turn in the car again. I think this is best in second or third stint. But then three wide. I'm wondering whether they'll do like you said and stick Marius, so we could be in for a battle of the century at the end of this.
Yeah, well, I hope it. But too bad I'm going to have to miss it. But I'm guessing that's the plan. Just putting Marius on the last stint and Ronnie for an independent sim race at GT2. So yeah, they should go out with a bang.
Sebastian's certainly in the places.
Yeah, he's doing better than on other tracks, and he's going for the inside. Yeah.
He's done it.
Yep.
Lovely stuff. Change the position. Sebastian now up into third. That's three more demoted to second. That lady still had seen in the end. 2 hours and 53 minutes to go. Still anyone's guess yet. No, I'm going to the toilet.
Okay. Don't fall in it. Yeah, the thing I thought just happened. Tree White just bit it and put it Mario's burden for the last 2 hours off. Whoa, he's 50 seconds behind on Sebastian Roan. So that was a real slow pit stop.
Paul's busy going to a party.
She's going well.
Oh, we have another fight for position 3, I think. No, position 4. No, that can't be right.
I'm always right.
Oh, no, that's true. Myers Bird versus Marco Pirani.
And we've got Romeo in the pits now.
Yeah, Philippe Noël just entered the pits on position 10. So, after 9 hours and 12 minutes, we have Sebastian Roan still leading over second place man Stefan Kanitz for All-Star Racing Team 2. For third position we have Tree White Motorsport with Marius Bird. Fourth position we have RSR Gaming Team 1, Marco Pirani. Position 5 we have GRL XF Racing 1, Karsten Willem. Position 6 we have GRL XF Racing 3, Jörg Vogel. On position 7 we have RML Racing Team 1, Robin Hase. Position 8 we have Independence Sim Racing GT3, Manuel Hanel. So I'm guessing that's Ronnie Hanel's brother on the sister team car or so. Position 9 is for Witchwood, Roman Ivanov. And our final for the top 10 as Racing Association 2 with Majas Viba.
Certainly not too bad, most of the field still in the race, only 4 disconnects. One of those was on purpose, so it's only technically 3. And Jake Bird.
Well, seems that Marco Pirani is trying to get closer to Marius Bird, but you know, Marius is a quick driver, so I don't think anything's gonna be possible, and he's even on fresh rubber, so I think he's gonna be fully concentrating on closing that 51 second gap. And yeah, he still has 2 hours half, so
yeah, and don't
it should be possible.
Don't forget that they've still got a pit yet as well. Pit, so that'll bring them back again, and still with 2 hours and 45 minutes there's going to be at least 2 more stops anyway, possibly 3. And a quick splash, so it's certainly not done yet.
It surely is not. And we have Karsten Willem, but he sure has yet to pit, I think. He's only on 11 seconds behind Marco Pirani and Marius Bird, so still a lot of position swapping could be happening.
bloody die.
Yeah. And I was going to sleep like 3 hours ago or so. Oh well. Oh, somebody was getting there out of the way there. And we seem to have another battle for position 7 and 6. With Robin Hasse right behind Jürg Vogel. So it should become interesting soon. Oh, fuck it to me. My apologies.
I thought I heard that right.
Yeah, I was talking to somebody else, but...
Yeah, I figured you were talking to somebody else. Yeah. I was just sitting here reading the timing screen, I was like, what?
Yeah, stuff like that happens,
well,
I guess.
And they say romance is dead, though.
And they're like three battles at the moment.
Sweeper off their feet, eh, Dimitri?
Oh, God.
Well,
oh,
you do know that's going to be on the broadcast forever.
Yeah. I'm not going to do that. Maybe I would get sacked, so...
Yes.
Well, Robin Haas is getting really close. The gap's only down to a half a second. So, he sure has some pace. Also seems Stefan Kanitz is closing down on Sebastian Roan. The gap is around 5.2 seconds now. So he's definitely losing time as Stefan Kanitz just does a 2:01, so 2:18. That's, I think, a personal best. I'm not sure, so I'm gonna check that out for you. Now, it's not his personal best, but it's a good time, and Robin Haas is looking at the inside, but he can't make it stick, so he has to let that go. You're a dirty-minded guy, really.
See, I'm not, it's what you've said, it just makes me chuckle.
No, I can't help it. Just, yeah, turn him side on now. I learned it from Bradley, so... Blame him. Okay, you go. He's going in the inside again. Come on, don't fall asleep.
No, I'm not falling asleep. I'm watching it.
No, you have to commentate, and he made it stick this time. So, clean move there from Robin Hase. And also, Marco Pirani had to let Marius Bird go. And he's actually slower, he's on 45 second gap now, so he's surely not making up the pace yet.
There's a few gaps coming down. There. No. Still not one. There.
RML Racing Team 3, camera 13. The battle's quite close now as well. 1.9 seconds to me.
Which battle?
Camera 13. Positions 11 and 10.
Yeah, good big commentary wide battle there. And Stefan is still going fast. He's still lapping 5/10 a lap faster than currently leader Sebastian Rohn. Don't talk about food, really.
I'm starving, man.
Nah, you talk about me all the time, then.
No, I've not eaten nothing since 3:30, ain't like you.
No, it was 4. I did. I ran out of chocolate, so...
Got my replacement anyway, or your replacement, and he does a better job than you.
Might that be?
Nico.
No, he's coming. When?
He'll be 36 minutes or there, there a bit.
36 minutes?
Yeah, that's just 2 hours.
Oh, darn it. Are you kidding me?
You said last 2 hours, it's yeah. 36 minutes. So he's having his dinner.
So,
and
yeah.
And then he said he's going to come round and knob drop you.
What, dinner at 10 p.m?
Yeah, 11's.
Well, I was about to go about 10 p.m, so.
Or yeah, else I'll get 10 killed. 10 p.m. in 35 minutes.
No, that's actually 33 minutes.
That's what watch you're looking at.
Hello, guys.
Local.
Here he is.
Ah, speak about the devil.
Seems to be that you guys are running short.
Yeah. No, it's just because it's cold. did you hear Dimitri being rude? So I'll give you a clue. I think he thought that no one could hear him, and he's turned to his girlfriend, and all her was, "I'm gonna F," and then he went. Where it was, "I'm gonna F."
I think everybody can make the story complete.
No, is she winding you up there, is she, Dimitri? Is she sitting there with no clothes on or something?
Nah, you don't want to know.
Can she hear us? Can she hear us? Tease him! Tease him!
too bad mistakes. It's not her.
Hello? Hey, now I know why Colson is going to be at that party. He's not a toy's round yours.
Nah, I just have to go at 10. That's why.
Yeah, we know why.
Yeah, of course, you know.
No pictures needed.
No, what pictures? No. You want pictures?
No, of course.
I bet she has to get.
If she's not Natalie Pinkham, I'm not interested.
Nah, he only wants Natalie. Who again?
Natalie Pinkham.
The one from Sky Sports, yeah.
Yeah. Tasty bird. There, did your testing go then, Nico?
Oh, I didn't do much. Had apparently dinner and went to dinner then. So I see that Sebastian Rohn has taken over the lead.
He has, for now.
I've been missing quite a lot, it seems.
Yep, but he's got another stop to do.
Yeah, but the gap is down to 2 seconds, so
yep.
He's gonna get
each. One stop behind as well.
Well, he could make this work.
For about 10 laps. Aye, what's up with you?
He can make this work, so...
He can. He can indeed. But still, we'll toss up between three teams for the win.
And still, Marius isn't matching the pace he should. So, he's not really pulling that much off the high gap between Sebastian and Marius, so... If Sebastian pits and Rocket Ronnie takes over, I'm like practically sure he should come out in front of Marius. So he made one jump already.
Yeah, but don't forget.
He needs to get.
He's got to make another stop to get to 10. And they've all got to make at least 2 by my reckoning. With 2 hours and a half going, that should be at least 2 stops and maybe a splash. So he's one stop behind. And it doesn't matter how you drive, you can't conserve enough fuel to save a stop, it's impossible. That means double stinting tyres, which Nico tried, and it don't work, and you can't get the fuel, there's no way is it going to last 60
at
laps.
At least it didn't work for me, let's make that clear.
Yeah, and my car didn't have any tyres on it at all, it seems. Stop.
If
Falcon Mineshaft are in the pits.
If I look to the lap time of Bert, it's like still 8 tenths quicker than Sebastian, so he's lost one, so...
Yeah, but he's not losing out too much. I mean, racing all-star team Stefan Kanis just was lapping 2 minutes and 1 second, so... Well, 2 seconds a lap, nearly faster.
Yeah.
Who we got any... Hey, I got a minute. Camera 13. Some action coming.
Yeah, you have to keep an eye on the front also. It's also only 2 seconds, 2.3 seconds actually.
Yeah, I should worry about that at the pit stop. It's not really going to matter whether he passes or not, there's another pit stop as well.
Yeah, as soon as he's going to get past, he's going to pit anyway.
Well, that's at least what I'm expecting.
Oh.
Ronnie's dad's pitted in the other car. The old GT3. So,
oh, that's his dad.
He is indeed.
Oh, I thought it was his brother, so apologies for that mistake.
Yeah, he's supposed to be fair, you've been making them all bleeding though. Fucking up the servers and ruining IP addresses. And... it's been a nightmare. You can't get the staff. Jesus.
That was a twisty range there from Mr. Noel.
My back's getting bloody sore, I'm gonna have to move. Old age is sitting in. It's alright for you youngsters. Give me a cushion here. Get me a mouse. Wires. There we go. Right. Excuse me. Right, we're off. What we got going on then? What's going on in the land of Italy? Down to the second now. To the front. Oh, quick. It's down to 3 temps.
Oh, yeah, here we go.
He's got square headlights. Seems even the Corvette's doing it now as well. This is it, Paul. You're right, and a Corvette. Crikey. What the flipping's going on?
No, I don't. Remember it being like this in last races, so...
No,
let's hope that we're the only ones seeing this, because for a driver it can be quite annoying.
Yeah, no, I think they would have all pulled in. Doesn't shut when we go on board, so I think it's just...
Well,
yeah, we're seeing It was alright until Demetrius started to pick them and then it just broke.
I'm gonna let you guys go now for the last 2 hours, so take care and hope on a good race finish, I would say, as Sebastian just pitted. I leave a few lads to it. Good luck.
Good luck, and
have fun. Speak to you later, man. Be good.
I always do.
Yeah, right. What the hell's going on here? What the hell's happening here? I'm going to mumble my freaking mouse now. But no control!
I do wonder if Rocket Ronnie is gonna take off, because his pit stop is almost over and still no Ronnie in the car.
Yeah, maybe he'll come on a bit later though. 2.5 hours remaining.
It would surprise me if they would do a swap in the last hour, because I think they can use Ronnie as early as they can.
Yeah, but then Sebastian's been whole race, which is pretty struggled at most tracks.
Oh, yeah, Ronnie Hainel is in the pit. Is in the car.
Not sure what we're waiting for.
Now, let's see if there are any close balls on track. Closest people together are Racing Association 2 with Matthias Weber, who is 1.5 seconds behind Philip Nolla of RML Racing Team 2.
RML
and for
Racing
the rest,
Team 2,
everything
yeah.
is quite split up.
Yeah, you get this a lot. You go through stages where you get like an hour or two where nothing really happens, and then for another hour everything happens and you can't pick who you want to watch.
Yeah, I hope that Ronnie Hainel, Marius Baert and Stefan Kanitz get together for like the last hour. I think we can see some brilliant racing then.
Yeah, like, definitely.
And maybe we get even something like the 24 Hours of Spa, where Alex Piccolo and I think it was Sebastian Hoen were racing each other in the last lap for the first position.
Yeah, it's been nice. I mean, he's got what? We'll sit 55 seconds to make up to catch him, which is a big ask, but it's still doable. And we know that Marius Baert's mega quick, so
and
the time that's left, it's easily doable.
And Ronnie and Marius seems to be very close, so if they work together, they might be able to get it quicker than expected.
Yeah, this is true.
Although, looking at the last lap times, Marius Baert and Stefan Kanitz had about the same time.
Yeah, we've got a counter in backmarkers, isn't it? That's the thing with these endurance races, it's one bad backmarker for someone might not necessarily be a bad one for someone else, and it can lose you chunks of time. I mean, the only advantage now is this blue flag rule is a lot more prominent in this race as it has been in others, so it's making drivers jump out of the way a lot quicker than they used to.
I think the track is also quite a good thing for the leading cars, because it's wide, fast corners usually. A lot of places to go well out of the way for the traffic, so...
Yeah, I discovered new areas of Silverstone earlier on in my stint.
Yeah.
Trying to get out of the way of people. Just being informed here by Christopher on the broadcast team Facebook page that Stream 1, our German colleagues aren't having issues with their light sensor.
Oh, that's why there was no sound. Well, people can always try this one.
Well, they got no sound on the German one. Cool. Hopefully they'll come over here. How many viewers we got? No, we're only on 6, so they didn't come over. Anyway, wishful thinking.
Well, let's
see what Ronnie's up to. Oh, hang on, that was a partial spec weapon, wasn't it? Where was we? We were now racing 2, wasn't it? Back. What's this for? No, that ain't for position, that's sim racing for Holland, isn't it? It's definitely not for position. Right, so back to the front. Because it's down to a second now. Between Ronnie and Marius. See, it seems weird, Marius, for the last wee while, their team, they don't seem to have the pace that they had for the first few hours of the race, so...
No, maybe he's getting tired, because he has been doing quite a lot of driving in this car today.
Yeah, maybe it's also that their setup works better in warmer temperatures. I mean, race started at 27 degrees, it's now 16.3, so it's, you know, it's a fair whack of temperature drop. So maybe their setup was more in that, you know, the area of we'll do it weekend when it's daylight and see where we are when it goes dark.
Yeah. Well, can you quickly check this week for a second? I can definitely say that Ronnie Hainel is on the deal of Bert and really waiting for a good moment. So, is it going to be first attempt a good one, or...?
Yeah, this ain't going to be worth... sure, hang on, he's going for it, he's got the inside line. Coming into the second to last corner.
Oh, but if it doesn't make
he's
it
taking
in
the
that
position,
one.
That's it. Ronnie's through. And I think Marius will just let him go because this is what he did earlier. I don't know whether it's to the extent, although he's not letting him go mega quick. No. Oh, hang on, that was a bit of lag.
It doesn't seem logic to let him go at this stage. Although there's still 2 hours and 20 minutes to go.
Yeah,
it's
so
not too many.
Because they had the disconnect, that I think they realistically know a certain position they can finish in. And I think that's what they're aiming for, which is why they're not... Because he wasn't defensive, he didn't, you know, block the line or anything, you know, which is how we've seen Marius earlier on, you know, during the day against Karsten and a couple of others. None of them was easy overtakes, you know, he was guarding his lines massively everywhere, and that was just, you know, it's like, if you want the position, just sort of go for it, you know, or leave the door open enough, which is that he did earlier, so I'm just thinking that... There's more to that than meets the eye. We've got X Factor Racing Team 3 in the pits as well.
Yeah, maybe he knows that the gap.
Foil.
Maybe he knows that the gap between All-Star Racing Team 2 is too big to be battling at the moment, and decides to let him go so they can catch up and then go for a battle.
Right, Nico. Options. Full conversation. Add files.
And RML Racing Team 2 is also in the pits. With Daniel Schuweck in the car. Wonder if they're gonna swap.
Where did I put it? Put it in my garage drive. USB cable once.
And the RSR Gaming one with Marco Pirani at the wheel is also in it for its 11th stop. And if we follow this pattern, I think they will have to do another two stops and they'll be the first to make their final stop of the top teams.
Where's the blooming way? It's on the drive that you've got, is it?
Sorry, he's pulled away quite a bit. Right, oh, what we've got going on here? They've closed the gap to 5 tenths, so we'll go back this.
Rodoni Hinnle is definitely closing the gap, but not as quick as they probably want.
Alright. Let's go around on here somewhere. There. Where's the raw file for it then? Did it my raw up again? Oh, I can't move. Annoy you when you know you got files and they're not where you expect them to be.
Horrible feeling.
Yep. Right.
And a beautiful overtake from Alex Rambo on Julian Seiden Biel. Oh no. Where is
it? Seiden Biel. No,
no. Oh, something isn't right here.
Yeah, no. Alex Rambo just...
Yeah, Witchwood is closely behind. Oh no.
What's big and bonking? I've got something big and bonking at me. Yay, yay, yay. That's that. Facebook going berserk again. Right, yeah, so this. Did we miss the overtake? Has it happened?
No, I didn't think there was an overtake, it was just that. Witchwood had a blue flag, I'm mistaken it for a battle.
Yeah, well, have we got any other closeness going on? I don't think we have, have we?
No, Witchwood is quite close to Philip Knoll.
Yeah. There we go. Is that right?
Yeah, this could actually turn into a three-way battle because Matthias Weber for Racing Association 2 isn't far behind him either. So, this could get interesting.
There they are, yeah, there's the car down there. I was going to say, I wonder where it was. It's Facebook doing as it's told you. Come on, man. Went to that one to upload it. Ay, ay, ay. This is the closest one we've got, which is... I don't know, is it gap up? Yeah, the gap's gone up to 3 seconds, but we've got...
But Matthias Weber seems to be closing in. Yeah, went from a second and a half to a second. But that might be because of the traffic, so...
Yeah, we'll leave it with him for a minute, see whether he gets caught. Because it's just a loud space, obviously, for... the X-Factor car to go past, so see whether it's back marker issues or whether he's slowing down, which is not, you know, you don't really expect Alex to be slowing down really, do you?
Oh, but it's Roman Ivanov driving at the moment.
RML Racing Team 1 are pitting.
Rummy's now 5 seconds clear of Marius, but he's still 52 seconds behind Stefan.
Yeah, the gap isn't closing as quickly as it should be.
No.
No, in the end it might just work, so...
Well, this is true. And the thing is somehow independent, so they've managed to stagger their pit stop by a massive difference, look, to half a stint's difference. So Stefan will be due in way before them, so it's going to be a matter of what Ronnie can do as a punishment as their tyres are going off, you know, because we know that Ronnie looks after tyres really well through previous races, so if he can, you know, why he hasn't got a pit carry on pushing, maybe he can get 10 to 15 seconds off of that deficit. I mean, he's just knocked it down to 52, so it might well be Stefan's tyres might be starting to go. This race is getting close, here we go. He's surely ain't going to try it.
And maybe he will do like in Spa, 24 hours, where they didn't pit for where they pitted for fuel only and didn't switch tyres. It would put them, yeah, it would save them 27 seconds. So, and if he can handle the tyres, then it should be quite a good thing.
Didn't you say you had to score it?
Yes, I did.
All right, add me, hang on.
Okay.
Is this Facebook's taking the mic? And I'll send it you on Skype, because otherwise the race will be finished by the time you get it. Too many pages open now. Let's see, Skype, where are you? Oh, there we go, I was right, Stefan's pitted. No chances of that happening. And I think we missed the overtake with these two as well. Good stuff. Cracking job.
Well, lifetime, he says that Matthias Weber is still behind Roman Ivanov.
Oh, yeah, he is, yeah. And camera angle as well. Oh, there we go, not too bad. Come on, Skype, hurry up.
What are you doing there?
Yeah, it says I'm online. But, yeah, there we go. Right, yeah. Right, yeah, get back to the race. Getting closer.
Yeah, one of these long straight, it's gonna happen at least. It's gonna happen soon.
Is he going to try it around the outside? Oh dear, well that was just stupid. Now how was Alex doing that? I mean, you don't block someone that late. It's just nuts. Jesus Christ, man. This year's late in the race, he realised he could have wiped himself out and ripped a wheel off. Seems to be the way with Alex, he has his way of doing silly things.
Oh, it's Roman Ivanov at the moment.
Huh? Oh, there you go. My apologies to Alex. Epic fail on my end again, caught in a cracking diamond. Oh dear. Right, what am I doing? That's it. haberdashery of this broadcast is what I'm doing. Alright, back up drive 2. And there it is. Skype.
Well, it seems to be that... Oh yeah. We have another close battle between All-Star Racing Team 2 and Tree White Motorsport.
You're set to not disturb. What battle where?
Between 3rd and 2nd. After the pit stop of... Stefan Kanitsi dropped back after Marius Bert.
Let's have a look-see. Yeah, your Skype's on Do Not Disturb, by the way. Oh, there you go, you're on there. Cool beans. So, now we want to whiz bang that over to there. There you go. And then the info you need will be... team speed.
And Brown Deck of GP Racing is also in the pit. Yeah, he won't lose place because he's one lap up. And it seems to be that... Oh no, I'm completely wrong. It almost looked like Lazy Man Racing was back in the race, since they aren't in the pit. But they're still disconnected.
Whoa. Is this a battle or...? No.
Ah, yes, it's the battle between 2nd and 3rd.
Oh, yeah, there we go, that's it.
Oh, will focus, he clear it? Focus. Oh, there's a back marker there, so...
What the hell am I getting free of here? What the chuff's going on here? There we go.
Obviously doesn't like people sending things on Skype. Flip right out then, I thought there was something going on with my PC, I thought Shane had been hacking me again. So, anything else happening? Anyone in the pit? Starting to spread out a bit now. We've got 2 seconds to which it's not to 3, so this does seem to be the closest battle. So it seems All-Star are the first to blink, making it stops now 11, whereas Free Wide and Independence are on 10 apiece. We know that Free Wide will pit sooner than them, so it'll probably put Free Wide back to 3rd. So it's still anybody's guess yet.
I think the main question will be, will Marius Bert be able to keep speed up without making any mistakes? But, yeah. I think it's starting to get hard for everybody since it's getting later and they've been waiting quite long by now, so...
You installed it?
Yep.
Right, click on connect. I'll go to file, I think it is, and connect, and the box will appear. And then in the long box, put your IP in, and the short one, put the port. And then that should be good to go.
Okay, now we are in business. Yep.
Alright, you
if you want to do your camera work, you see on the live timing.
Yeah.
And you see the numbers in red in the first column.
Yep.
Right, that's the numbers for the camera.
Ah, okay.
So, like, you got car 1, which is in position 1, is 6. And then you got, like, position 4 is 2, so it's whatever the numbers are. And if it's a double number, you got to press the numbers as quick as you can. Oh, hang on, we've got a server crash.
Oh, no,
we might get away with it. It's just, it's not a server crash, but... I've got a feeling Lutz is going to restart the servers anyway. Yeah, we're still good to go. The Cullen has said earlier, if they get one more driver mismatch or something or other, they're going to restart the session. Because where there's been a few, we've got a car in the pits, which is LSF Racing. So Julian Seedby deal.
Well, if there's going to be a session restart, it will definitely mix up the field a bit more and make it all more exciting, so...
Yeah, I mean, it'll add an hour onto it as well, so we'll go up to a 3-hour race if it's a case if it happens now. And obviously, it'll bring the, like you say, it'll bring the field a lot closer, so we could be in for a good race towards the end. I mean, we're all sitting here trying to figure out what happened with X Factor Team 1. They just... their points just dropped. They're back up to 4th now, but they've been, really bounced back. It's just bizarre.
Yeah, maybe it's because Maximilian isn't as fast as the other ones, maybe.
We saw it with Carsten, because I think, if I remember rightly, they had some sort of mini disconnect or something or other went on. But I think with the weight ballast they're carrying, I don't think they can run the pace. So maybe they've just taken the decision to try and, you know, make the best situation that's out of their control. Because I think it's 3 wide in it. In the, I think they're in contention for the win for the season. I think. And obviously, we've got 24 hours of. Just life of the go, which is a final round of the season, so it's going to be these two are still at it. So this is what I'm finding weird, because he didn't race like this against Ronnie. That's why I'm wondering whether there's something more that meets the eye with that, because he just let him go.
Yeah, I think he thought that if he didn't. If he didn't battle him, he would be able to keep up and just follow him, but apparently he didn't play out as planned.
Hmm. It's certainly, thingy bobbing, but then saying that, he's only 11 seconds behind him anyway. And it's like you say, if these two work together instead of doing that.
Oh, and there's contact between.
Instead of doing that, they might be able to reel Ronnie in. We could have a 3-way battle. But then saying that, you still got 3 wide and Ronnie. We've still got a pit. What the hell was that bonging at me?
I don't think we'll see a 3-way battle, because Ronnie seems to keep making the gap bigger. So...
yeah,
he's really going for it.
So they've got... they're a stop down and so are 3 wide. So Marius and Ronnie, so at the minute, the race is in All-Star Racing Team 2's favour.
Well,
and they're favourites as it stands. Just don't forget, before they all pitted a minute ago, there was a 58 second lead that Stefan had, so I think that's why Stefan's trying to clear him as quick as possible. Because this is exactly what I was saying. See, Ronnie staying out, a bad car to pass, isn't a good thing necessarily for one, but brilliant for others. See, and you saw how easy Marius let Ronnie go, and he's not letting Stefan do the same, and he knows there's that 58 second deficit. Is it the fact there maybe that you've got a team, maybe 3 wide aren't best of friends with All Star Racing, and they're trying to do Ronnie a favour?
I think that he may have done the same as he did with Ronnie if Ronnie didn't run out as much as now. I think he knows that he's slower pace, has a lot slower pace, and that he just can't allow him to get past and let him get away. I think it's going to be something like this, because if the car, if they overtake now, it's actually they are behind even more than they are now.
Yeah, I mean, there's definitely something going on there, but sort of see, there's certainly something weird.
But it gives us a great battle.
Because I can't see any advantage to Marius holding him up, because Marius has still got a pit, and he was 58 seconds behind before Stefan Pit. He's not going to bring that deficit down. Yeah, they're side by side on track, but he's not going to gain an advantage, because as soon as he pits, obviously average pits about 50 seconds. So if anything, Marius is going to lose out more and more and more and more to Ronnie, because he's 11.5 down now. And yeah, Ronnie's got to stop, but whatever happens, if Ronnie doesn't make a mistake, when he pits as it is, he's already going to be where it's going to have gone up to 12 seconds clear of him. So it's...
Oh, we have a car stepping the gravel.
Where?
Just in the corners we just passed. And that is Flat Spot Racing. I think they wanted to get well out of the way of this battle, but
yeah,
then went a bit too far.
That's our last running place car, I do believe, yeah, with Craig Moore at the wheel. So yeah, they've had a good race. They've been there all the time, really, you know, kept their noses clean. They're running good lap paces as well. They've done the best laps at 2:03. Their last lap was their last, that ain't coming up yet. That means they've just crossed the line. Like that, but yeah, they've been, you know,
yeah, quite
it's
a good
matter of learning,
that,
isn't it?
Yeah, they did a good race. Seeing that
there we
this
go,
is
Marius
their first
has just
one.
Pitted. That's Marius in the pit. So it's a matter now of seeing how much this has affected Stefan in comparison to Ronnie, which was where we assumed the big competition had come anyway, was between those two drivers, or two teams, I should say. So how much will Ronnie gain on him? He's 11.4. So it's going to be a matter of waiting now, see what Ronnie can do between now and when he stops, to what the deficit's going to be when he comes out. This is going to get exciting in the next 20 laps or so. While they're doing that, have we got any other battles to watch? There's not really anything going
well,
on.
Well, the next closest together are... Yeah, the closest guys are the one at the front.
Yeah.
And with that pit stop, it's gonna change a lot, so...
Yeah, we'll, what we'll do with Ronnie. Oh, we got a temp car. Who the hell is that? We heard this earlier. I don't know who's beyond Ronnie on track to know who that is.
Well, let me see. That is... Oh, who was the latest person to get a disconnect? Let's quickly see.
The last... What's your discount?
No, but I have seen their car, so it can't be them.
No, there was another one, and no other than Witchwood. Wilgrave, that was the last one to get disconnected. So if we go to Wilgrave quickly. No, because their car's... Oh, that's not Wilgrave. Yeah, it is. No, so it's not them, then. Who the chuffing hell is that driving around in a temp car, then?
Oh, let's use the track map then for a second.
Yeah, because he's right behind Ronnie. He doesn't seem slow on pace either. Wherever it is.
And it is Alex Piccolo from Witchwood, so...
So they've had that's what that mismatch was. Remember a minute ago and the message came up, that's who it was, Alex. So whatever they've caused, the chances are they're going to receive a penalty from the race stewards. It's about seven times, I think, today that somebody's caused bits and pieces, it would be the terminal, whether it's a an actual R-factor issue that's caused it, or whether it's due to them not sinking, which I can't see, because Alex has been on quite a lot. He's done a good few stints, and it's the first time it's happened, so...
Oh, Ronnie goes very wide.
Yeah, and also, Stefan's got the gap down. And it's coming down bit by bit, aren't we? This racing with Alex here is costing him. Alex shouldn't be challenging because they're not racing for position.
Well, I don't know if he really is... Yeah, it will definitely distract Ronnie, but if you're a back, you're not doing nothing wrong, actually. You're just...
Oh, no, I mean, oh, he's not doing anything wrong. He's letting him go.
He's overtaking him.
No, he's letting him go.
Well, that's quite strange, but yeah.
Probably just thinks it's easier to get him and let him run off than...
Oh, but now they're... Oh, he just dear. Drove him off the track.
Oh, Ronnie. Oh, I hope he don't get a penalty for that. Oh, but Alex will be fuming now. We've got RML in the pits, and we've also got Falcon Mineshafter in the pits as well.
I think every team should get its own name. It's quite confusing with RML replacing team 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, and X Factor. And Independence.
I thought RML again in the pit, but apparently nothing, no big deal.
No bad. Falcon Mineshaft have had a few. They're on 13 stops. The biggest still yet is Flat Spot Racing on 18. So, running an unusual pattern there.
GRL XF Racing is Racing 1 is coming back, is 2 seconds behind 3 Wide Motorsport. So maybe we'll get a good battle there.
Yeah, let's have a little floaty boat. We haven't actually had the thingy yet, Flat Spot on a while. Let's give them a bit of air time. We haven't got anything massive going on. Oh, the cameras won't change now. Let's try that. There we go. Flat Spot Racing.
Yeah, driving with a livery that looks quite hard on the one of WRT Racing, a real life racing team from Belgium who drove FIA GT1 and Blancpain Endurance Series. So, I think they're fans, I would almost suggest it. I've taken a look at their car and they've all the same sponsors on their car, so I would doubt if it's for another reason.
Alright, that's that done. There. Right. So while we're just having a natural fact, what we'll do, let's have a driver's round a little lap. Oh, that's good. Oh, hang on. Who's that just pitted? Max has pitted. X Factor Racing 1 have just pitted.
No, this is a shame because it was looking like a promising battle between him and Marius Baird.
And so. Stefan's got the lead down the gap to Ronnie down to 7 seconds.
Yeah, I think they may be
quick to go on the Longstar Racing.
I think they may get the upper hand.
And they've been quick on other tracks, certainly since I've been done, and I didn't see half a season, but watching them come through, you know, every race they've been getting faster and faster and faster, and would certainly say that they're now one of the top teams, easily. The pace that some of the drivers have got is pretty ridiculous. We're getting a lot of aliens in this league. Which is good for them, but it's bad for the rest of us.
Oh well, we might be slow now, but if we stick to them, we might learn something from them and get better.
Yeah, I mean, I reckon by 2055 we should be right up there, wouldn't we? You never know, our Factor 2 might be released by then as well. Ooh, three wide ring of pits again. Oh, why is Mario's pitted again? Oh, quickly, let's
no, I think they're going to switch driver because
let's jump.
It's really struggling, so...
They've disconnected. They've got to have done, because there's no car there.
Well, life timing is a bit slow then, but...
Because according to this, he's in the pits right now, and this... We should be in the onboard camera here.
Oh, maybe they are trying to do some adjustments to the setup or so. I don't know if it's allowed, but... Yeah, could well be that they are trying to do just that.
Yeah, but even at that, you got a disconnect to do it. They're not there.
Let's try
another car. Let's try Ronnie because we had this earlier. No, Ronnie's still there. Why is it there? Let's just give this a minute then. This could be a big change. Oh, they're definitely not there.
This is definitely going to help Stefan and Ronnie Hanel to find out who is going to be the winner in the end. It's quite a shame because Tree White has been so well in this race.
Yeah, I mean it's still not saying disconnected on the right timing yet, but sometimes it takes a couple of minutes to come up, but there's definitely no car there at all. It's either that or I'm as blind as a bat all of a sudden. We'll keep our eye on that and let you know. Meanwhile we'll jump to, at the minute we've got, it's not a mega close battle, but we've got two going on at 4 seconds apiece with Racing Association against RML, so we'll quickly jump across and see, is that right? That's not RML. What's gone on here? Yeah, let's try that again, shall we? Let's put the right number in right out, that should be, yes, is that RML? Yeah, there we go. But we want the car behind, so we want this. There we go, we're on the ball. Eventually. No, Maris still isn't showing there's a disconnect yet. There's something going on with the live timing though. I'm not showing any disconnects and I'm only showing down to...
Well, maybe they are still there because if they disconnected we wouldn't have been able... We would have seen the guy driving in place 3 then. We didn't see them.
No, not necessarily. Because that won't change until they catch up in time. Even when they're in the pits, even if they disco, you've got to, each car to change the position on the leaderboard has to catch up the time deficit. It doesn't just wipe off. Yeah, so who's the car behind is RSR Gaming 1, and according to this, the gap behind is 2 minutes 15, yeah, so they've got to basically do a lap and a bit to get that place, and that should be around about now. We should see if that changes positions. But there's something going on, I'm going to have to do a lot of time because it's playing silly buggers here.
Three wide motorsports can all really give it up now.
Three wide have gone into fifth place.
No way for them to get the win, if you ask me. They were getting slower and slower, so don't expect them to get them really good suddenly.
What the hell's going on here?
Oh, I will get an error.
I think we've got a server crash, because according to this, Marco Marco Perini's in first now, followed by Nicholas Matheson.
Oh, no, Vogel. Server is still going.
So what the hell, where's Ronnie gone then? And all the others, where did RSR come from?
Oh yeah.
What the heck's happening here? I don't understand any of this.
Four position one. No, hang on.
What's happening? Right, there we go. Yeah, no, it still shuts at 7. And according to our live timing, this is your race leader.
Independent Ronnie now is in 5th position. Stefan's back past him, but yet Ronnie's not pitted. So I'm completely lost to what the hell's going on here.
Well, I can't follow either, but the only way this is possible is that Stefan Kanitz overtook. No, that all the people. Stefan Kanitz, Jörg Vogel, Nicolas Mekshin, and Marco Pirani.
Our all factors crashed. I was waiting for that.
I think
we're just about on the verge of a server crash because the live timing's gone to pot and all. So. I'm going to try and. No, what am I clicking on here? Get out of the way. Yeah. What the hell?
Well, let me try.
Yeah, same thing. Right, hang on, got an idea. Can you read German?
Yes.
Yeah, there you go.
What do you want?
Open. Launch the game as admin or open, whatever.
Ah, shall open.
There we go. Now, the live timing's back, but it's showing still RML. Well, they're in the pits, but it shows them in the lead.
Ronnie Hainel dropped another four positions.
I'm wondering, and they're in the pits now, I'm wondering if they've had a disco as well. This is
bizarre. Something is really going wrong.
Really going on, yep. This isn't quite what's we're left over.
I'll let you do the mouse.
And, okay. Oh, I've missed a digit off end, no. Bollocks. I mean, two knots. Wait for the timeout now. Crap it. Oh. Am I typing that in right? I am, isn't I? I haven't hit caps lock, have I? Yeah.
Maybe I had caps lock, maybe that's the problem.
Yeah. Oh, hang on. What's happened here? Oh. I'll get you on and you try the password.
Okay.
Oh, hang on. The server's gone.
Let me check TeamSpeak. Yeah, a lot of people are in the support, so I'll join support and get the latest news.
Yeah, see what's going on. Yeah, no, server's gone, ladies and gentlemen. So, we'll try and find out what's going on and let you know ASAP, but it looks like we may have had a server failure. So, we could well be having another hour of extra racing once we get going again. We'll let you know as soon as we can. While that's doing that, I'm going to quickly reset the broadcast.